Hello students, welcome back. In the first part of this active passive voice series, we have seen that how to convert affirmative active sentences into passive voice, right? And now in this second part of this series, we'll see how to convert negative or interrogative active voice sentences into the passive voice. So before we start this, we'll see the rules. We'll quickly revise the rules. These are the all same rules, nothing new. Okay, only few changes are there to convert negative or interrogative sentences into passive. We'll see in detail, but just let's quickly revise it, these seven rules first. First, that is our first rule, is that object of the active voice will becomes the subject of the passive voice. First rule, main verb of the active voice change into the V3 form, that is past participle, third form of the verb. Okay, second rule. Now the to be form is placed before the main verb. Okay, so in which tense, which to be forms are used, we have discussed it in a deep. Fourth rule, auxiliary verb that changes according to the new subject in number and in person. So now how auxiliary verb change according to the new subject? New subject, that means object of the active voice, which becomes our subject in passive voice. So that is our new subject, right? So how this auxiliary verb change according to this new subject? That means in the matter of number and in the matter of person, right? Next, the subject of an active voice will become the object of the passive voice. Easy, add by before the subject. So these are our six basic rules, and one more is there, that is our pronoun table. Let's take a look. Okay, now here changes in pronoun. Now in act, while we form this act, while we convert active voice into passive voice or passive voice into active voice, this particular change we have to do, that is when it comes to pronoun, all the subjective case of pronoun will become the objective case, and all the objective case of pronoun will become the subjective case. It is like the subject will become object, object will become subject. So same thing is here. Now no change in this possessive case. So this seven rules are there. Now let's start it with the negative structure. Now in active voice, our sentence structure would be like this. Look at the example. Ram did not eat an apple. Ram did not eat an apple. Now Ram is our subject. Did is the supporting verb. If did is not used, then auxiliary verb is used in any negative sentences, right? Not is just put after this supporting or auxiliary verb to frame it negative. Then our main verb will come, right? And after this main verb, what will come? Our object. So this is our negative structure of active voice. Now let's see the passive voice structure. Now subject will become object, object will become subject. So object will come first, right? And after object, we'll have to put to be form. Here it is the simple past tense. Now simple past tense to be form is was or were. Now an apple is the third person singular, so we have put here was. Okay, so object to be form, then we'll have to put not just after it, right? And after this to be form, after this not, what will we put? We'll put our main verb in third form, that is V3, because it is the rules of passive voice, right? And after that we will add by, and after by we'll add our subject. So this is what the structure of the active passive voice. Now Now, if the sentence note is given, if the sentence has an auxiliary verb, put it before not. Okay, here we have seen that sometimes it may happen that it has a supporting verb or auxiliary verb. Now, supporting only two tenses needs this supporting verb, that is simple present or simple past. Now these two tense need supporting verb, that is in simple present it is do does and in simple past it is did. Otherwise all the tenses has the auxiliary verb along with their main verb, right? So now if the sentence has auxiliary verb, now this sentence doesn't has auxiliary verb, right? If the sentence has auxiliary verb, put it before not. So we have to put it before not and we'll put other things after not. For example, Ram will not eat an apple. Now in this sentence, look at this, will is given here, right? Will is given here. So Ram will not eat an apple. So again, what will we do? We'll put our object first, then we'll put our auxiliary verb, then we'll put not. After not, we will put to be form. Okay, then our main verb, then by, and then subject. Look at this sentence, earlier sentence, we don't have this auxiliary verb. Second thing, if you observe it, then we have removed this did in this sentence. You can't find is then in this sentence, can you? No, it is not there. Why it is not there? Because now we have this to be form, so we do not require the supporting verb anymore. So that is the only reason. So only in active voice sentences of simple present or simple past we require this supporting verb, that is even to negative or interrogative. I know it's a bit complicated. Let me repeat it. What I'm saying that we are talking about two tenses, that is simple present and simple past. Now in these two tenses we require supporting verb. Which supporting verb? Do, does and did. So now these three supporting verbs are there, right? Now we need these three supporting verb to frame interrogative or negative sentences. But when we transform those sentences into passive voice, we do not require those supporting verbs. So we will just put to be form, only to be form. And instead of this supporting verb, if auxiliary verb is used like this sentence, here we have auxiliary verb, that is will. Okay, if it is used, then we will put just before not. Here we have what we have done, we have put to be form, we have already put this to be form. If instead of this supporting verb, auxiliary verb is there, so what will we do? Before to be verb, we will not put to be verb first, we will put our auxiliary verb first. So here will is there, so we will put will, and after not, we will put our to be form. Look at this, here be is there, right? After not, to be form is there. I hope I'm clear now. You will get it with the examples, so don't worry. Now let's see these sentences. In simple present negative structure, example would like this. He does not write later. So now we'll have to change into passive. We'll put our object first, later. Now we'll put to be form as it doesn't has any auxiliary verb. Then we will put our to be form. What is the to be form of simple present? That is MR. Is goes with a later, right? So to a later is, we'll have to put not because it's negative. Not written by him. Okay. Now if you remember how to frame passive, just do one thing. Put not just after this auxiliary or to be form. That is what the funda of this negative structure. Otherwise, you can go with this long theory also. He didn't write a later, or he did not write a later. Again, a later, will not put this did because it is a supporting verb. We'll have to put to be form, that is was or were. Now was is used because a later is there. So later was not V3 form of write, that is written. We'll put by before our subject. He is our subject. So objective case of he is him. So later was not written by him. Simple future. Now in simple future it is very easy because it has the auxiliary verb, right? So we'll have to use those auxiliary verb only. We do not, now these two tenses are, you know, they are like a master, we have to treat them differently. So these two tenses we have to be very careful regarding these two tenses, otherwise all the tenses are very user friendly. So you know it's very easy for you. Simple future, let's see it. He will not write a letter. We'll put object first, a letter. We'll use this auxiliary verb as it is here only. Look at this, I have put the note here. Do not write do or does or did in the passive constructions. It's most important thing. Do not write do, does or did. That is our supporting verb. We don't have to write here. Look at this. I haven't written here does, did. Can you find it? No. Okay, so do not write these things. Second thing is that if auxiliary verbs are there, that means this will, is, am, are, or any particular verb. So if it is there, then write them before not. So we have to write them before not. The same thing which I'm talking about. Okay. So he will not write a letter, our object, a letter. We'll have to write this auxiliary verb. So we'll write this just after our object. Then we will write not. Even our rule says so. So we'll have to write not. Then we will put our to be, then our main verb, that is even V3 form, by, and then our subject in our objective case. So later will not be written by him. Now let's see some of the example. I do not distribute newspapers. I do not distribute newspapers. Now what will write, what newspapers, supporting verb is used, so we don't have to write it. Instead of supporting verb, what will we write? To be form. So now it is do is here, do not distribute, that means it is a simple present tense. So to be form of simple present, that is am I. So what goes with these newspapers? Are, newspapers are, we'll have to put not as it is negative. Newspapers are not. Now to be form we have already written, so we won't repeat it. Newspaper are not V3 form distributed by, I will become me. Newspapers are not distributed by me. Let's see another example. She does not buy mobiles. Mobiles, will cut this does. Instead of it, what will we put? Mobiles. Now this our new subject is in plural, so are, mobiles are, negative is there, not buy V3 form, bought by her. Mobiles are not bought by her. I did not see him. He, why he? Because him is in the objective case, so we'll have to write subjective because we are putting it as a subject. So he did, we'll have to cut did also. So he, now it is the past tense. What goes with past tense? Was or were? Was. He was not V3 form seen by, I will become me. He was not seen by me. You did not pay the bill. The bill was not paid by you. The bill was not paid by you. I shall not cook rice. Rice, shall or will. Now we have these auxiliary verbs, so we'll put these instead of to be. We'll put to be after not. Okay, so rice will not. Now we'll put to be form, that is here be, right? Rice will not be to be form of v3 form of cook, that is cooked. Rice will not be cooked by, I will become me. Rice will not be cooked by me. Look at this, right? Now continuous tense. So all the to be form of this continuous is being here. Instruction is there, write auxiliary verb before not. The same thing we have talked earlier in the future, simple future tense, same things goes here, right? He is not writing a letter. What will be, how we can convert it? First we'll write object, that is a letter. What is our object? A letter. Now we'll put to be form, not to be form, auxiliary, which is here is given, right? So here this ismr is not to be form here. Okay, they are supporting this ing form, that means it is supporting v4 form. So here in the continuous tense, consider this ismr as in auxiliary verb. Okay, in simple present they are the to be form, but in continuous present continuous they are the auxiliary verb. So in here in this line I have mentioned the to be form of this sentence, to be form of this continuous tense, it is being. Okay, don't mix it up. So we'll have to write a letter first, then our auxiliary verb is goes with the letter, we'll have to put, then our not. Okay, to be form, that is being, so we have to put it after not. Then our main verb will change into v3. I have forgotten here to write by plus the subject, that is by him. Okay, so letter is not being written by him. Next, he was not writing a letter, same thing. Okay, a letter, what goes with a letter? Was or verb? Was. A letter was not. Now to be form of this writing, being written by him. He will not be writing a letter. A letter will not being written by him. But the thing is that there is no, we can't change this future continuous into passive voice. If we can, then as I told you, it could be changed like that, but it sounds very strange. I hope you get it. So no change in the passive voice when it comes to future continuous tense. Okay, let's see some of the example. She is not purchasing a house. So a house, what goes with it? Ismr is not, of course. Now to be form of it, this tense is being, v3 form, purchased by subject. Who is subject? She. So it will become her. A house is not being purchased by her. The farmer was not plowing the field. The field was not being, now plowing will become plown by the farmer. Let's see the answer. The field was not being plowed by the farmers. Next question, I am not cutting a tree. Now it is the negative interrogative. Not is written here. Sorry, I'm so sorry. I don't know what I'm talking about. Negative sentence. Simple in present continuous. Okay, I am not cutting a tree. A tree, what goes with a tree is not being V3 form of cutting, cut by me. A tree was not being cut by me. Okay, next. They were not distributing the sweets among the children. Past continuous tense, right? The children, what goes it with it, were not to be form being V3 form distributed by them. The sweets were not being distributed by them among the children. Extra words are there, right? Okay, now how it works in the perfect tense. In present perfect tense, the active voice sentence structure would be like this. He has not written a letter. A letter has not been, I have made a spelling mistake here, you don't make it. A letter has not been written by him. He had not written a letter. A letter, will put the same auxiliary verb here, had, will have to put not, to be form, here it is been, because we are talking about the perfect tense. Okay, so to be form of any perfect tense, that is been, so we'll have to use that only. So a letter had not been, then our main verb will convert into V3. We have V3 form on already. Okay, then by, then our subject in objective case, that is he will become him. Next, sorry. In future perfect, he will not have written a letter. Now look at this. This sentence, this tense has a two auxiliary verb, that is will and have, and after that our main verb will come. So this tense has two auxiliary verb, so we don't have, so what we have to do, we'll have to just put not just before the first auxiliary, other remaining auxiliary will put before to be form. Okay, so before to be form, we will put this another remaining two auxiliary verbs. Look at the answer. A later, okay, object. Now first to be, sorry, auxiliary form will, and just after first auxiliary form we'll put not. A later will not, other remaining auxiliary, that is have, to be form, that is been, main verb in third formation written, then by, and our subject in objective case, that is him. A later will not have been written by him. Okay, examples are there. He has not eaten a banana. So what we'll have to do, we'll have to put a banana first. A banana, our auxiliary is here, as, has is here. So I think has a banana is there. So has, of course, it goes with has, banana. A banana has, we'll have to put not. Our to be form of this, it's been. A banana has not been, V3 form, eaten, then by, then our main subject in our subject in the passive formation, that is objective case, that is him. So a banana has not been eaten by him. Next. They have not plucked the flowers. The flowers, our first auxiliary verb that is have is there, and I think it goes with the flowers because it is plural. So the flowers have not to be formed been V3 plucked by them. The flowers have not been plucked by them. He had not played a football match. A football match had not been played by him. Let's see the answer. A football match had not been played by. I'm sorry. They will not have planted a tree. A tree will not have been planted by them. A tree will not have been planted by them. She will not have sold our houses. Our houses will not have been sold by her. Our houses will not have been sold by her. Okay, now when negative modal auxiliaries comes, so then the same thing as I told you earlier, then we have to treat modal auxiliaries as a simple future tense only. Okay, but in simple future tense we use will or shall as our modal auxiliary or supporting verb or auxiliary verb, right? Here we have to put the main whatever the modal auxiliary is used in the sentence, we have to put the same thing. Look at the sentence. He should not abuse others. Now what will we do? We'll put this object first. So others should not to be form be is there, right? In the simple future tense. So same thing applied to here also. So others should not be abused by him. I know I'm writing like a doctor. I'm so sorry for this. Others should not be abused by him. Right. Next. He may not have done the work. The work may not have done by him. Now this, it has the other auxiliary verb also. Okay, so we'll have to treat it as this earlier, as we have seen, if two auxiliary verbs are there, then what to do? The same thing will apply here. The work may not have done by him. Okay, now let's start with the interrogative sentences. First we'll see this structure. So in interrogative sentences, especially in active voice, these kind of structures would be there. First auxiliary or supporting verb will come. Here will here we have will. Look at this sentence. Will he eat an apple? Now this is the formation of active voice interrogative sentences. So will is our auxiliary or supporting verb, right? We'll have to put auxiliary verb or supporting verb. Supporting verb, that is do, does or did. If do, does, did is there, so we'll have to put in place of this will. So that's the reason that I have mentioned here. After this, we'll have to put our subject, then our main verb, based on the tense, right? Then our object and question mark. And how to convert these things into passive? So first we'll write this auxiliary or to be form, as we talked about earlier, that we do not have to write this supporting verb, that is do, does or did, which we use in simple present and in simple past. So we have to cut this supporting verb. Instead of it, what will we write? To be form or the auxiliary verb. If auxiliary verbs are there in the sentence, we'll have to put auxiliary verb. If the sentence doesn't has auxiliary verb, that means they have the supporting verb. So we'll have to cut the supporting verb. Instead of it, what will we put? We will put to be form. The same thing is written here. Look at this. Do not write do, does, did. Okay. And if auxiliary verbs are there in the sentence, write them in the beginning to frame the interrogative, right? That is what our sentence structures demands, right? And after this auxiliary or to be form, we'll put object, then to be form. If to be form is used here, then there would be no to be form. So we'll have to cut these things. Only it happens with these two tenses, simple present and simple past. As I told you, they are the masters. We have to treat it differently. So after it, we'll have to put V3 form of the main verb. We'll put by, subject and question mark. Now one thing I would like to tell you students, many of you students get confused with these two things, that is direct, indirect and active passive. Not just the students, but I have seen many of these teachers are even. Okay, so one thing I would like to suggest, that in active passive we are not changing tense, we are just putting the to be form according to the tense. The same thing applies with the punctuation marks even. So we in direct, indirect, what we have to do, we have to transform every sentences into simple sentences, into assertive sentences, because we are reporting at that time. So if someone has even asked or expressed something, we have to report it into a very simple assertive sentences. We have to give the statement, we are giving report, right? So that is the reason at that time we have to convert all the things, and we have to even remove this question mark or exclamatory mark if they are used. But here we have, if these are the negative sentence, we have to keep it as a negative. If they are interrogative sentences, we have to treat as them, we have to convert them into interrogative sentences only. Okay, so don't forget this punctuation mark. If question mark is there, we'll have to put question mark. Okay. So this is what our interrogative sentence structure. Now there is a note which might help you. Okay, use to be form in place of auxiliary verb. So look at this, to be form in place of auxiliary verb. If there is no auxiliary verb in the sentences, that is simple present tense and simple past tense, as I talked to you earlier, that if both these tenses doesn't have auxiliary verb, so they need some support. Okay, so supporting verbs are used in these two tenses. So if they are used, we don't have to write it, we have to write to be form in place of auxiliary verb, right? Now example is given. I have taken from both the tense example the same thing which is here, right? Does he eat an apple? Will he eat an apple? Does he eat an apple? Now it is the simple present tense. So now does is the supporting verb. We'll have to cut it. Instead of it, what we'll have to use? To be form. Now what is the to be form of simple present? That is is, am I. Now what is our object here? An apple. So what goes with an apple? Is, am I? Is. So is then our object. Then to be form we have written here, so we don't write it again, right? So is an apple. Now V3 form, what is it? Eat will become eaten. Then by, then our subject. I have mistakenly put Ram here because earlier we have put that. Okay, you don't make mistakes. So instead of it, what will we write? Him. Question mark. Right. Okay, now same things applies here in the past tense also, simple past. Let's see. Did he eat an apple again? We'll have to cut this did. In place of this did, we'll put to be form because auxiliary verbs are not there. So which verbs are to be verbs are to be verbs goes with this sentence? Okay, this sentence is in simple past. So was were. Now let's see what is our new subject. Okay, an apple will become our new subject. So what goes with an apple? Was or were? Was. So was an apple. We have already written to be form, so we'll not put it. So what will we have to, we gonna write V3 form. So what is that? Eaten, right? By our subject in objective case, him, question mark. Okay, I hope you understand. It is very basic and it's not that much burdensome. If you get it once, it would be easy for you to frame, convert active voice into passive voice. Now let's start with this simple tenses. Now as you know, the to be form of simple present, that is SMR, simple past, that is was were, simple future, that is be. Now the same rules which are noted earlier, the same rules are there. Do not write do, does, okay, because they are supporting verb. So we'll have to cut. In place of it, what will we write? We'll write to be form. If auxiliary verbs are there, then we have to write auxiliary verbs. Okay, the same rules are there. Let's see. Does he write a letter again? We'll cut this does. In place of does, what will we write? To be form. But which to be form will goes with it? Will decide the our new subject. A letter is there, so what will goes with a letter? Is, MR, is. So is a letter. Now we have already written to be form, so we are not going to repeat it. So is a letter V3 form of the main verb written by him, question mark. Is a letter written by him? Did he write a letter again? We'll cut this. Did. Was or were? Was. Was a letter write will become written by then our subject, him, question mark. Will he write a letter? Now auxiliary verbs are there, so we'll put the same thing. And here also same thing, that means don't, if shall is written, so don't write shall only. Yeah? Look at this, our new subject also. So if here I is there, then you have I or V is there, you have to put shall. Okay, so will a later. Now our to be form of this tense, that is be. So be V3 form written by him, question mark. Okay, the same rules I have mentioned here, so you can understand in a better manner. Do you obey your elder brothers? Sorry, elder brother. Now what is our new subject? That means what is object here? Elder brother. Do you obey your what? Do you obey your elder brother? So your elder brother. Now do will have to cut do. So instead of do, what will be write? To be form, because these are the supporting verb, right? So elder brother, third person singular. So is your elder brother, to be form is already written, so we'll not use it again. Is your elder brother obeyed by you, question mark. Is your elder brother obeyed by you? Next. Does she pluck the flowers? Again we'll cut this does. What is our object? The flowers. Okay, so what will we put? The flowers is there, so to be form first. Yes. Are the flowers plucked by her, question mark. Are the flowers plucked by her, question mark. Next. Did Anmol open the shop? Now we'll have to cut did, because it is supporting. In place of it, we'll put to be form. what goes with the shop, it is the simple past, was. Was the shop opened by Anmol? Question mark. Was the shop opened by Anmol? Did she eat and eat the mangoes? The mangoes. Now did, we'll have to cut did. What will we put? The mangoes are there, plural. So were the mangoes eaten by her? Were the mangoes eaten by her? Question mark. Will they praise Geeta? Now here we have auxiliary verb, so we'll use that only. So will Geeta, will have to put to be form because we haven't used in the sentence, we have used only auxiliary. So will Geeta be praised by them? Question mark. Okay, let's see the answer. I haven't seen it. Will Geeta be praised by him, by them? I forgot to put question mark. Okay, now continuous tense. As you know, the any to be form of any continuous tense it is be. Okay, and consider this or is or was, is MR or was were as the auxiliary verb because they are necessary to frame continuous tense. So they are not auxiliary verb. Okay, they are in some of they are the auxiliary, they are to be form, but we'll have to treat them as an auxiliary verb because they are supporting main verb here. Okay. Is he writing a letter? So we'll have to put is MR only. Is a letter is there, so we'll put is a letter. Now continuous tense is there, so we'll put to be form, that is being. V3 form, that is written by, then our subject in objective case, who is subject, he is there, so him in objective case, and question mark. So is a letter being written by him, question mark. Next, past continuous, was he writing a letter? Again a letter, but a letter, that means a, okay, so was or was. So was a letter, now to be form being, V3, written by subject, him, question mark. Oh, sorry. Now there is no passive voice of future continuous tense. Okay, only these two tenses. So there are total 8 tenses are there which we can transform from active to passive. Let's see some of the example of this continuous tense. Are they plucking some flowers? So some flowers. I have mistakenly forgotten to put S. Some flowers are there. So some flowers is MR, what goes with it? Are some flowers to be form, what is it? Being plucked by them, question mark. Are some flowers being plucked by them, question mark. Right, were they abusing the others? Now the others, was or were, what goes with it? Were the others being abused by them, question mark. Were others being abused by them, question mark. Is he not flying a kite? Of kite is there, so is MR, is a kite. Now it is the negative interrogative, but we'll have to deal with as the same thing only. Okay, now these are the mixture of negative interrogative, so it don't get confused. It's also easy. We have to just put not in the sentences to frame it negative interrogative. Okay, we can't cut it. Okay, so a kite, what goes with it? Is a kite not, now to be form, being flown, V3 form of flying, flown by him, question mark. Is a kite not being flown by him? Next sentence. Was she not driving a car? Was or were, what goes with here? Was a car, we'll have to put not. Was a car not, to be from being driven by her, question. Was a car not being driven by her? Sorry, where does it goes now? Okay, here. Okay, one more example is there. Were the farmers not sowing seeds? Again, object is here, sowing seeds. Now, what goes with sowing seeds? Were, because it's plural. So, were sowing seeds, we'll have to put not. Then after, to be form, that is being. Sowing will become sown, V3 form. Right. So, were seeds not being sown by the farmers, question mark. Were seeds not being sown by the farmers? I hope you get it. Now we'll move further with the perfect tense. Nothing new. We'll have to use this auxiliary verb in the beginning. We'll put to be form just after it. Okay. After our object, if another auxiliary verb is given, then what we'll have to do, we'll put first auxiliary at the beginning, then we'll write our object, and then we'll put a remaining auxiliary, and then we will put to be form. The same thing is written here. Look at this. Has he written a letter? Has, then our object, a letter, matlab has or has, that depends on the subject, our new subject, that means object of this active voice. So has a letter been written by him, question mark. Had he written a letter? Had a letter, to be form, been, V3 form, written by our subject, him, question mark. So, had a letter been written by him? Future perfect. Will he have written a letter? Will, first auxiliary, right? Then our object, a letter, remaining auxiliary, have, to be form, been, V3 form, written by, then our subject in objective case, that is him. That means will a letter have been written by him, question mark. The same instruction is given here, that write auxiliary verb in the beginning and after object, that means our subject of the passive, and use being, that is to be form. Okay, here we have to use been because it is our to be form. Have they won the match? Example. So we'll have to have or has, the match is there. So has, right? Has the match. Has the match. Now V3 form, been. V3, sorry, to be form, been. Now V3, that is worn. And then we'll put by our subject in a objective, that is them. We'll have to put punctuation, that is question mark. So has the match been won by them? Question mark. Let's see the answer. Has the match been won by them? Sorry. Had he knocked at the door? Now look at this. At the door. Had he knocked at what? The door. So the door is our object. So it will become our subject, the door. Okay, the door. Now knocked at is the phrasal verb. I hope you learn it. It is connected with this verb. So that is what phrasal verb. Okay. So the door. Now what goes with the door? Had, of course, in past tense it is very easy. Only one auxiliary verb or supporting verbs are there. So had the door, to be form, been, then our V3 form of the main verb, knocked by him. Had the door been knocked at by him? Question mark. Had the door been knocked at, I forgot to write by him, you can place it here just after act. Will they have planted a tree? Now a tree, of course, will goes with it. So will a tree have another auxiliary? We have to put it. So will a tree have been planted by them? Will a tree have been planted by them? Question mark. Shall we have sold our house? Our house is there. That means shall or will? Will. Will our house, another auxiliary, have to be, that is been. Will our house have been sold by us? Question mark. Will our house have been sold by us? Had she not washed the clothes? Had the clothes, negative interrogative is that, so we'll have to deal the same thing. Okay, had the clothes not been washed by her? Question mark. Right. Now the model auxiliary, interrogative model auxiliary, the same things are there. We'll have to treat it as the simple future only. Okay. Can our team win the match? We'll have to use the same model auxiliary. So can the match be, to be form, right? Be won by our team. R is the possessive case, so we won't change it. Can the match be won by our team? Question mark. Should they not buy a house? Okay, we'll write the same thing. Should a house not is there, so we'll have to put not first, then our to be form. So should a house not to be from be bought by them? Question mark. Should a house not be bought by them? Would Raman not have won the match? Again, negative interrogative is there. So would the match, we'll have to put not before the to be form, but here we have another auxiliary verb. Okay, so we'll put another auxiliary verb first, then our to be form. Okay, so would the match not have to be formed? Is be. But now look at this, have is used here. So wherever have is there, we'll have to use been. Would the match not have been won by Raman? Right. Now you have to keep it in your mind that have is there. Right. So whenever have is there, so we'll have to. It is like will have. Now where this will have come, will have B3 is there. Look at this sentence. Would have won. Okay. Will have B3. When it comes, will have B3. When it is future perfect. So would have not, would have plus V3 is that. That means it is this perfect future. We'll have to deal with it as a future perfect tense. Okay. So wherever have is there, you just write it as a. You have to mention this. You have to put this to be form. Which to be form you have to put, that is been, right? So would the match not have been won by Raman? Okay, finally we are at the end part of it. In the next video we'll discuss how to convert where if the two objects are there, that means the direct object, indirect object, then what to do, how to convert them. Then we'll also see the ought to model auxiliaries. So we'll see the next, and we'll also see the quasi passive, or maybe if possible, and we'll see how to convert vice versa, that is from passive to active. Hope you like this lecture. Keep studying. Have a good day.